Okay, we're on Eduyot, Perek Gimel, Mishnah Gimel. More machloket between Rabbi Dosa and the Chachamim. First machloket. Me'e avatiach. Me'e avatiach is the zeronim seeds v'amashke and watermelon juice. The melon seeds and the juice. Uknivat yarak. Kniva is alim upashim, like rotting leaves. Shemisibim in yarak. You take off, like you get the tomatoes and you pull off the stuff that's falling off. So of truma. So if you have a watermelon of truma or vegetables of truma, and you have these, and you have this, the watermelon seeds or the liquid, the juice, or the rotting or the disintegrating leaves. Rabbi Yedosa, Matin Lizarim. Rabbi Yedosa says that even though it's truma and truma only goes to Kohanim, you can give these things, the watermelon juice, to non-Kohanim Zarim. Because he holds it's not, he says that's not food. It's not, it doesn't have a din of food, and therefore it doesn't have the din of truma. Okay? Mechachamim also, Mechachamim say no, they are of the din of food, and they are considered truma, and therefore even those things you cannot give to Zarim. Next halacha. The next halacha is based on the halacha called Reishi Tagez. So let's look at Mishnah Masechet Chulin. This is Chulin. Perek Yud Alef Mishnah Alef. Reishit Gez, the Torah says, Reishit Gez, I should show it to you, but you should look it up in Dvarim Perek Yud Ched. Reishit Gez Tzonachat Titen Lo. You have to give the first shearings of your sheep, you give to the Kohen. So, one of the things Mishnah says is, Reishit Gez Eino Noeg Ele B'Recheilot, it's only for sheep, Eino Noeg Ele B'Meruben. And it's not every sheep, it's only if you have a significant amount. And the Mishnah says, how much is it? Let's go down. Pamahim Meruben. Beit Shammai says, "Shtei b'chelo, two sheep. Shneimar yichayet ish eglat bakar shtei tzon, two stone together." Beit Hillel says, "No, chamesh, five." So Beit Shammai says two. Beit Hillel says five. And then Rabbi Dosa ben Akinas Omer, because Rabbi Dosa says chamesh b'chelo gozozot mane upras. So we're going to come to Rabbi Dosa here. Chayovot reishit agaz. So if you have five sheep, when their shearings come to a mane upras, is a fancy way of saying 1.5 mane. Honestly, I have no idea how much that is. Kahati says 600 grams. Okay, then chayav reishit agaz. Let's go to our Mishnah. Back to our Mishnah. Chamesh mechelo gezuzot maneo maneo press. How much is reishit agaz? You have to have a minimum of five sheep where their shearings are maneo maneo press. Okay, each one is maneo mechetzi. Okay, 1.5 maneo, 600 grams, I guess. I guess a maneo is 400 grams. Ubatzir mehachi lo chashim gez. Less than that is not gez. Shizel pachot shebigizot. So if you shear your one sheep, you don't have to give the kohen. So that those are chayavot reishit agaz divi Rabbi Dosa. The chachamim amrim, chachamim say chamesh v'chelo koshkim, five sheep. Remember, let's go back to our Mishnah. Five sheep is Beit Hillel, five. So five sheep koshkim any amount. Now the Bar Tinura says, the Gemara says, it's not any amount. Lav davka, it's not any amount. They say pachot mishim shlaim lo mechayav reishit agaz. Meaning it has to be 12 slaim worth of shearing, okay, per sheep. How much is a selah? Does the Kahati say? 12 slaim. Okay, the 60 selah for all five. Didn't say how much that is. Anyway, if you want to know how much 12 slaim are, a selah is 24 ma'im. And each ma'ah is 16 garinesa or barley seeds. So 16 barley seeds times 24 times. Selah. How many selah do we say? You get the point, figure it out on your own. When you figure that out, email me the selah amount. Tell me if you think shearing is a minimum for the Chachamim. We'll dedicate a learning to my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. And when you get that answer, you email me at rspalter@gmail.com. Have a great day.